the BJP's biggest gains in 2014 came from UP and from Bihar. UP, of course, we have the SP-BSP alliance this time, which is the personality of Narendra Modi was the caste arithmetic of UP. But Bihar is a different ballgame altogether. With us is Sanjeev Singh at the TOI's data center. Sanjeev, break down Bihar for us, because Bihar is going to be absolutely crucial to the BJP's bid to come back to power.
Nalin, in 2014, BJP had got very good alliances in place. And Bihar was a shining example where they picked up smaller parties and helped them garner a lot of vote share, in which resulted in 22 seats for them. That's more than half the seats they had won. And if you count the alliance that they had RLSP and they had LJP. So that's another 9 seats.
But unlike UP, Sanjeev, where they had the big sweep of 2014 and then the big sweep in 2017 in the assembly elections, where Adityanath became chief minister, in Bihar, if you can go to 2015, the first big reverse for BJP after 2014 was also in Bihar.
That's because, you know, you saw after the 2014 results, both Nitish Kumar and Lalu Yadav realized that if they had to somehow keep BJP in check, then they have to come together. And it was actually Nitish Kumar who took the initiative and went out of his way to try and appease the RJD leader, and they had an alliance. In that alliance, we saw that despite BJP polling the highest vote share, it was RJD and JDU that actually swept the entire state and they came to power. Then, of course,
now, of course, Nitish Kumar and Narendra Modi are back in the same alliance. There's a whole debate, of course, about Paltu Chacha, which is what the Congress charges, which is what the opposition charges, or whether he's the Babu of Sushasan. So how is Bihar panning out now?
If we can go to the alliance simulator that you have, you see that even now, if we put RJD, RLSP, NCP and the Congress together, the vote share is not as much as, you know, what we saw in UP.
So if I can explain it to those who are watching, I am assuming, Sanjeev, correct me if I am wrong, we are looking right now at vote shares of 2014.
Yeah.
We assuming there is no change in the vote share,
yeah,
and you put together INC, RJD, RLSP, NCP together and see what happens on the ground. Of course, in the real election, things will change. People will vote differently and so on. But we are assuming that nothing changes with JDU, BJP together. BJP is still, NDA is still getting 34 seats according to this calculation.
Yeah, there are two major reasons for this. One is that the vote share of BJP was extremely high in 2014. And at that time, JDU and RJD were fighting separately. Mm. This time, the JDU vote will add to the BJP. So, they are already at a high and they will get that extra support from JDU, which is why, despite, you know, all the other parties coming together, you don't see much change in the landscape of the forecast that we have. NDA still gets 34 of the 40 seats going by the vote shares polled in 2014.
This mathematical calculation.
Yes.
But of course, Nitish Kumar, of course, has always had a history of going piggybacking on the dominant party in Bihar for a long time. If you can just take us through the last few elections, Sanjeev, to give us a sense of how Bihar has changed politically and the prospects now for both RJD and for BJP.
Let's go to 2004. This is the Lok Sabha election, and that time, this is when Lalu Yadav was at his peak. He had won 22 seats. Like in 2014, BJP, it was RJD in 2004 that won 22 seats. And when UPA came to power. But after this, we've seen, Lalu Yadav fade. And it was the emergence of Sushasan Babu, Nitish Kumar, along with BJP.
In 2005.
In 2005 assembly election. Similar sort of results you will get in the next, in the 2010 assembly election. And it was only after 2014 when Narendra Modi wave swept Bihar that you saw the sort of changes that we've talked about in alliances.
So net, while the national narrative is much more competitive now than it was in 2014, the arithmetic, at least on the ground, from what our data simulator is showing, the challenge for the opposition is far huger in Bihar than it could be in UP or in other parts of the Hindi heartland if they want to displace the BJP.
Yeah, simply because the vote share was so high for BJP last time around. If NDA's vote share goes down, which could be a possibility after the BJP and JDU have...
So let's say what happens if NDA comes down by 5%. Let's see what happens to this seat projection.
I don't think it will have much of
an
effect.
See, it is still winning 33 seats out of 40.
Yeah, so even if 6% vote comes down, there's not much effect happening. Let's try and add
5% for the UP alliance.
6%.
You're still winning 31 seats. Now this is a big electoral challenge arithmetically for the opposition. That even if they have the ballast of momentum with them, the numbers are the gap they have to surmount is very, very huge. So that's the big challenge for Bihar. We'll of course keep having these conversations on the elections as we dissect the 2019 election state by state.